the surface and is essential to all life, both in the sea and on the land. There's one animal that is the perfect ambassador for the ocean, and that is the Orcinus orca, or killer whale. In just a few minutes, you'll meet SeaWorld's killer whales. First, though, let's find out more about these remarkable animals. Orcinus orca, or the killer whale, is the most widely distributed mammal on Earth. They can be found throughout the ocean, all around the world, including in the Arctic, the Atlantic, the Southern, the Indian, and the Pacific Oceans. No other single marine species lives in as many different ocean habitats or is as directly reliant on as many different types of marine life as the killer whale. More than any other marine animal, Orcinus orca is the very embodiment of our shared global ocean. Until about 2 decades ago, scientists didn't know that there were actually several different varieties or ecotypes of killer whales. With effort and observation, however, we discovered that there are actually 10 distinct ecotypes, each differing in size, behavior, diet, lifestyle, and appearance. A striking characteristic of the orca is their black and white skin. This camouflage is called destructive coloration. In a murky environment, this coloration can make them difficult to detect. Killer whales are countershaded. Their top surface is darker than their surface underneath. From below, looking up, they blend in with the light from above. From above, looking down, they're invisible against the dark clouds. Killer whales are warm-blooded and breathe air, just like men. Killer whales are the largest members of the delphinidae, or dolphin. As you can see, they have impressive physical characteristics. Orcas have keen eyesight, both above and below the water. The dorsal fin of an adult male can be up to 6 feet in height. The powerful pectoral flippers and tail fin can propel them through the water at a high rate of speed with great maneuverability. Their top speed is nearly 30 miles per hour.
Dedicated our personal and professional lives to caring for these amazing animals. It's a huge responsibility and an ultimate privilege to be able to care for, teach, learn from, and develop relationships with our whales. We are proud of what we do, and we are honored to be able to share that with you today and for years to come. We hope you enjoy Orca Encounter.
You hear the way You know, these behaviors help keep our whales active and engaged. SeaWorld's killer whales have inspired generations to care about our natural world. We're excited to share their story, following you here today.
Killer whales are the ocean's top predator. They use cooperation and communication, not just size and strength, to take their place at the top of the ocean's food ladder. At the bottom are small animals, like krill. At the top, the apex predator, the killer whale.
Now it could weigh several hundred pounds.
just physical. Mental stimulation and play are vital, and we surprise and engage with our whales at every opportunity. Play is how killer whales teach their young to hunt. For the adults, play is important too. It seems that they just enjoy having fun. Making time for play is an important part of life for killer whales and for us.
Well, hi everyone. I am joined by my friend Micah. She is all the way from Indiana. Hey, Micah, do you like to play? Do you like to play?
Yeah, so do I.
Well, observational learning and mimicry play a critical role in the killer whale's lives. And from the moment they're born, they'll learn by watching other animals and play to follow the leader with their mothers. Do you want to play follow the leader with my buddy Truett today, Micah?
Yeah.
Go ahead and take two hands high above your head and wave hello. Check it out! We pair different parts of our bodies with different parts of the killer whale's body. So hands to pectoral flippers. Try stomping your feet and see what happens. And he stomps his tail flutes! Well, killer whales are curious animals too. Now, they've often been seen jumping out of the water to spot their prey, get a better look at their surroundings, or even play. Now, we're going to ask Ohio to do a sighting now. So when you see him, come on over to us. Remember that check mark I taught you? Here he comes. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay, he's off to do that sight bound laser. So proud he's behind me. When you see Makayo do that big jump at stage, we're gonna give him a round of applause. Excellent!
Okay, I think I see what's happening here. It looks like the kids are trying to show off over there, but that's right. Because I'm hanging out on this side with my new best friend. His name is Justin. He's from Canada. Let's hear it for him! Size of Q. So we got a bigger whale, we're gonna do a bigger jump. We're gonna do a jump called a breach. Now killer whales breach when they're playing. Sometimes they breach to stun their prey, but most often they breach to show off. You ready to show off? Let's do it. Alright man, you're gonna stand just like that. We're gonna make sure True is watching you. Go for it. Nice signal, Justin. Now he's gonna make his way down to the bottom of the pool on that run. Every good killer whale trainer knows you always keep your eye on the whale. So Justin, get real close. Yeah, perfect. Yep. Stay right there, real close, and then he's gonna make his way up. Justin, I was so sorry about that.
However, can only be obtained through field observation. That's why we partner with organizations like the Norwegian Orca Survey and NOAA to help advance global education about killer whales. Killer whales are powerful cooperative animals, and perhaps the best expression of that power can be seen when they hunt.
Killer whales stand apart. They have no natural predators, and just about any other ocean animal can be their dinner. On where they live and their chosen prey, they've developed some epic hunting techniques. Off the coast of South America, killer whales will teach themselves, riding in on waves just long enough to catch prey. They'll also create waves that knock animals like penguins or seals from icebergs. Most importantly, they cooperate, communicate, and coordinate as a team. Here's footage of killer whales corralling a small
Depending on where they live and the time of year, their prey items could vary. Unfortunately, factors like overfishing and pollution pose a serious threat to some populations of killer whales.
Killer whales are impressive animals, and it's pretty obvious why they're the top predator in the ocean. That means killer whales are invincible, right? Wrong.
Killer whales depend on a plentiful food source and a clean environment. They're completely dominant, yet completely dependent.
When it comes down to it, killer whales are not the most powerful animal in the ocean.
Jump! our kid. Thanks again, everyone, and we hope you enjoy the rest of your day at SeaWorld.